In the last video, we were talking about distances of planets from the sun, and we saw that Mercury is about 0.4 AUs from the sun, Venus 0.7, Earth 1 AU, and we see it's just sort of a convenient unit to use, and we can say things like, again, Mercury is about half the distance from the sun as we are, Venus is about 70% of the distance from the sun as we are, and they're just more understandable numbers. Mars is about 1.5 times further from the sun than we are, and you see off it goes, Jupiter 5.2, Saturn 9.5, Uranus 19, and Neptune on up to 30. So what this sort of means for us as a scale then with the solar system is that really the solar system and distances we need to worry about sort of going to extend between 0 and maybe 100 AU. That's about the extent that we need to worry about for the solar system. But it turns out then, I just wanted to tell you about a few more things. There's some other terms out there that have to do with distances and making measurements in astronomy, because distances can be so large. Like the first one in particular that you might have heard of is a light year. So it turns out that a light year, although it sort of seems to imply it's a time, like something about a year or something like that, a light year is actually a distance. And formally, sort of as a definition here, it's the distance light travels in 1 year. So it might sound kind of odd to have something like that, but it's very very useful. And what it means is that if you maybe had something like a flashlight right here, something like that, and you turned it on and some light came out and it sort of started going this way, and you let that light travel just on its own for 1 year, so somehow you figured out how to replace the batteries or whatever to keep the flashlight sort of on for 1 year, how far would it get after traveling for that 1 year? So literally, like, maybe you started on New Year's Day, turn it on, and just let this beam travel and travel and travel and travel until the following New Year's Day, how long would it get? Well, we know, for instance, the speed of light, and that's why this is so useful, is something like 186,000 miles per second. So take a minute to reflect on this number here. 186,000 is a pretty large number, and this is miles every second. The term that you're probably most used to thinking of in terms of speed is this good old highway speeds of 55 miles per hour, for example, here. So that's another unit of speed in there. So this is 55. This is a much larger number in itself, 186,000. We both have miles in the top, miles here. This is miles per hour, but this over here is miles per second. So it is true that the speed of light is incredibly fast. And so, well, how far is that light year then? How far can light travel in 1 year? Well, if you take this 186,000 miles per second and just multiply that by the number of seconds in a year, which is about 31 million, something like that, seconds per year, you can sort of just calculate that, 365 days, whatever, that's how long you leave the flashlight on for, that all equals about 6 trillion miles. And 6 trillion miles in terms of our AUs translates into something like 64,000 AUs. So you see, although a light year is a distance that you might have heard of before from science fiction or movies or whatever, it's about 64,000 AUs. So if I scroll back up to our sort of statement here that our solar system sort of occupies distances between 0 and 100 AUs, we just don't need the light year to talk about anything in the solar system. It's just too big of a unit. Our solar system that we're interested in is going to stop at about 100 AUs, but the light year distances keep going out to 64,000. So a light year is cool, you know, we love it and stuff, but it's just not something we're going to make any use of in this class. It's just too big of a unit for us, so we don't need to worry about that, although it is interesting how long it is and where it comes from and that sort of thing. The next distance that also comes up from time to time in astronomy and science fiction is something called the parsec. And what a parsec is then is something like 3.26 light years. So it's very similar to a light year. It's just sort of under four times as many light years, four times the length of a light year, but it's just another unit that's out there. And again, and just in terms of these light years and parsecs and that kind of thing, the solar system here, again, we just need to stop at about 100 AU, so we don't even need the light year. But just for reference here, in case you're curious here, the nearest star to us, now keep in mind, our sun, which is a star, is one AU away. So technically that's the nearest star, but let's say the nearest star that's not our sun is about 4.2 light years away. And the nearest galaxy, other galaxy, outside of our own galaxy, is something like 2 million light years away. So all I'm trying to tell you by this is that there are just some curious facts. These are just the nearest things, 4.2 light years away, way outside of our solar system here, something like 24, 30 trillion miles, something like that. Then the nearest galaxy would be 2 million light years away. So just way, way, way outside of our solar system.